when you want to get off the darkest ground. The gravity pulls you straight down. Earth from a bird's eye view. You should grow feathers and see this too.
We'll be right back. Gentlemen, boys, and girls, welcome to Sunday Night Action in the GMHL. Joe Todd, the voice of your Bradford Rattlers. Who are they taking on? They're taking on the Lynx, the West Nippising Lynx. They're here. Let's see what this game has in store. We got Timofev and Broomberg back in the lineup. They've been back for at least two games. This will at least be the second game. And we're lucky tonight. We have back with us the great, the powerful Bill Fiennes. Hopefully he joins us soon. He'll be up in the booth soon here. Here comes the face-off. Cameron Nealon to take the face-off. There he is, the great Bill Fiennes. Missed him last week. His voice was definitely missed. Bill, how are you?
Good, Joe. I listened on the internet, and you had a couple replacements in for me. So
I did. I had my son in the first period. I had a player the second, I think. And then the third period, I had Connor or something like that.
Well, they did a good job.
Yeah.
I didn't even know if I'd get the call back this week.
Well, my son had to go to bed, so he had to stay home.
Is he getting ready for the big guy next week?
Oh, yeah. He's getting pumped. Pumped up, ready to go. Just like these Rattlers putting it in front. Nobody home. Here come the Lynx. In between the pipes. Good save. It's Joshua Lund.
Lund,
the boy, you recruited.
Yeah, Lund back in the net tonight and supporting a 8-2 record here, Joe.
Yeah, Bradley Hampton and Cole Jacobson looking on from the stands. So we got Isla Shurin backing us up. And just for the record, Bill, the last time we had these boys on, Justin Roy was in net. Tonight we got Igor Ignatov. He was very, he thought it was funny, our Roy Waugh little spit there.
Well,
he enjoyed it.
We sure weren't making fun of it.
No
it
way.
It was
no.
Just, you know, if we offended anybody, we sure didn't want to do that.
Well, we didn't offend him. He was happy.
We're just having a little fun with
it. He said we can call him whatever we want, just not late for dinner on Christmas.
Absolutely. It's nice to see 22 back in the lineup for the
But he's going to be
Rattlers.
The third line, Bill.
Timofev.
Yep, third line.
Got injured here a couple weeks ago playing Temiskaming.
Yep, big hit. But he's back, you know, trying to get his legs back underneath him there.
He's a tough little competitor.
Oh, so tough. Bap and Chow back as well from an injury. Timofev over to Bap and Chow. Bap and Chow have to chase that down. Bappenchow gets it center ice. Throws it in over the blue line. That's sticked aside. Hit the mesh, Bill.
Yeah, we talked here last week, Joe, or a couple weeks ago, about that new player that come from the Rattlers, number 13, Cameron Nealon from Newmark, California.
We did a little playing for the San Jose
Sharks, AAA U18 team. Yep. Did a little research. He had a little success there, and talking to the coaches here, he's fit in very well here, and he's done a good job.
Like he was on the team the whole year.
Absolutely. He's got some speed and some size.
There's a correction. I actually had Peter Kennedy, the cameraman's father, in for the second period. He played a little hockey himself before his knees got bad.
Well, that's usually what happens. This game takes a toll on knees and shoulders for sure.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, Joe, so you're ready for the festive season coming up?
Yeah, I got one more game with the Bulls on Wednesday, and Monday with the Steam and the Bulls on Wednesday, and then I'm on holidays, buddy.
The boys will like that.
Yeah, Daddy will be home every night. We're having the last inside the GMHL today.
That went quite well with Bob Russell.
Oh yeah. And you were a guest host again. I love having you on, Bill.
Well, you know, and I enjoy coming down from the big city there to participating.
Well, I got the permission right from the source this time. I called your wife directly.
Well, she mentioned that, and I wondered why there was a note in my lunchbox there telling me that I could come.
I bypassed you this time. Here comes Dutraville. Over the blue line, he gets picked off. There's a whistle.
There's a
slash, Bill.
There's a penalty going to the Lynx right off the bat here. Number 98, I believe. It's going for the box for slashing.
Who's that now? That is Nick Gribbins. Rats come away with that, trying to set something up here on the power play. There's a shot. Good save. Another shot. Another save.
They're going to put the... test this goalie early for the the Lynx.
Kuchuk Yildiz will take the face-off. Face-off win by the Rattlers. Broomberg. Over to Hedsberg. Back to Broomberg. Over to Kuchuk Yildiz with a shot. Wide of the net, just off target. Hassan with it. In front. Kuchuk Yildiz got a couple shots off, but taken care of. Another shot there. There's a whistle.
Looks like the...
another penalty.
No, I think, Joe, I think the net come off the moorings there. Oh. And
no penalties. Nope. I lied.
No, the... number one for the Lynx, his name is Igor Inek. He's from St. Peter's, Russia.
Yes.
Petersburg, Russia.
Hassan. Nice pass to Broomberg, and he puts it in Broomberg style.
There's that cross-ice pass. And
they love that.
They love it. That's their go-to play, and most teams can't figure that one out. That defenseman there, they got to get down and make sure that doesn't get across there, and it gets over to Broomberg there. It's going to be in the back of the net, and again it was.
And it was, but we have seen some teams shut them down on that. I just, for the life of me, I can't remember who it was. Niagara. Not Niagara, New Tech.
New Tech, I'm not sure what team did that to them a couple weeks ago, Joe.
Yeah, I can't remember, but they did.
They played, this team here is playing the box, where that team that shut the Rattlers down that night played the diamond and took away that cross-ice pass.
That's right. Bappenchow took that for the team there. Preston Kopp to take the face off. He wins that one. Chasing it down is Vlasic. Kopp helps out, throws along the half boards. Here comes Preston Kopp.
Preston Kopp just ducked that. He almost got run over there, Joe.
Yeah. Jake Awan getting it up the ice to Preston. Preston brings it over the blue line. Jake Awan helps out. Shot. Good save there. So we're 15:01 left here in the first period. 1-0. There's your shot. Lund hasn't seen a lot of them there, Bill.
No, he's had one nice little save there early, and the Rats are out shooting the Lynx here about 6-1 here early in the first period.
There they are, Lynx center ice, trying to do something with it, getting over the blue line. Pass got away from him. Simpson getting in there, putting on the pressure. Good hit there by Rezanowski. Oh, it tucked in, Bill. It tucked in.
Nice play by 68. Number 3 was right on the doorstep and jammed that in, but a nice play by number 68.
Did he put it on the back of his leg and it popped in?
I'm not sure. I thought it popped in front and
maybe.
Made a nice play.
Either way, it's in, and that's a tie game, Bill.
It's 1-1, and that'll get Mr. Lund's attention, I'm sure.
He's awake now. Timo Fev sends that up the ice over the blue line. Broomberg putting on the pressure. Hedsberg getting it over to Ruslan. Broomberg over to Hassan. Poke checked to keep it alive here in the Rattler zone. Hedsberg. Over to Hassan. Over to Timo Fev over the blue line. Glad to see him back in the lineup, Bill.
Yes, he's, like we said, he got injured there against Temiskaming near about 3 weeks ago. And he's just got back here. I believe he played a little bit here last week against Orangeville.
Yeah.
Just in certain situations.
On the second line, Bill. Bernberg coming over the blue line. Picked off. There's a shot. Good save by Lund. They cleaned up the garbage. Offside there. So, unfortunately, Bill, Wyarton has folded, but should be interesting 2017, what it brings. Going to be some crazy hockey, I think.
Well, unfortunately, you're right. They had to fold. Their team just wasn't competitive enough to play with these other teams here, but... there's a lot of other good teams here, and when we talked to Mr. Russell, half of those players already in the first few days got picked up and went to different teams, and that's what you like to see. It's pretty 100%. Difficult to fill those teams in December.
Yeah, absolutely. I hear even Niagara picked up one, so should be interesting 2017.
Yeah, that's a team that's as good as Niagara picking up a player, so it just shows they had some talent there, but just not enough.
Absolutely. Matt Barrett trying to do something with it. Gets it center ice. Cameron putting on the pressure, but not enough as Nippising Lynx. Oh, we got a delayed penalty, Bill. It's going to go against the Rats, I believe.
Yeah, I believe. I'm not sure what the call is, but
possibly tripping.
Both referees got their arms up, so it was pretty obvious what happened from down there. Not sure from up here.
Matt Barrett, go to the box.
25. He's going for tripping.
Yep.
So we're going to see the Lynx's first power play here early.
Should be interesting. 12:29 left in the first, tied 1-1. Oof. 5-on-4 hockey. Shot. Good blocker saved by Lund there, and he's got some height.
Yeah, he stands about 6'3", and young man, and understanding that he's going to get a little bigger, too.
Yeah, here comes the Lynx on the attack. Foiled by Broomberg. That's how you kill penalties, Bill.
Yeah, put the pressure on it. Broomberg didn't let up on it. He just stayed on until he finally made up the Lynx player to cough it up.
Hedsberg's on tonight. Look at him play. He's getting that puck down every time. Lynx dump it in along the halfboards. It gets shot. Stopped short there. Cameron gets it up the ice, Bill.
Yeah, if you're gonna play that dump and chase in there, you got to get it deep and put some speed on it. It's kind of, you just lofted in there, Joe, and it got caught up into the corner.
Yeah. Noah Little sending it up, giving us 53 seconds left in the penalty. Here come the Lynx. There's a shot. Good save, Lund. Garbage cleaned up, thrown out. 35 seconds left in the penalty. 11 minutes left in the period. 1-1, Bill.
Yeah, Rattlers are putting lots of pressure on here. It's right in the neutral zone, and the Lynx are having trouble getting it over.
Absolutely. Oh, that got away from Cameron trying to capitalize on that mistake, and he does. He comes around the net. Ooh, the pass got away from him. Bap and Chow have to chase that down. We've got, 7 seconds left in the penalty.
Lund had a couple saves there, but nothing too difficult for him.
Nope.
He's seen it all the way coming in, so no trouble making those saves.
That kills the penalty, yeah. 5-on-5, good save, Lund, there.
Bad angle shot, but Lund come out and cut that short side off.
So I understand that after the Orangeville loss, you weren't here. That's probably why they lost, but they went back to their barn and took the revenge.
Yeah,
7-2.
Yeah, the Rats turned it around.
They're pretty embarrassed at the loss, and but Orangeville Ice Crushers turning it around, so I wouldn't be too embarrassed. They're playing good hockey.
Yeah, they've turned it around here. They've got a couple good guys behind the bench there, Nate King and Jeff Oliver.
Yep.
So
Skinner.
Yeah, and so you'll notice a little difference in their play.
Players are happier. It's good. Nice hit there. Hedsberg, I don't know, he just seems on tonight, Bill.
Yeah, he's throwing his weight around a little bit, and that's good.
And getting the puck out, and yeah, he's where he needs to be right now, head-wise. Chipped into the corner. Ruslan sees it. Pressure's on. By Schwarzkin, number 8. What is it, Schwarzkin?
I'm not sure how you pronounce that, right, Joe, but you keep doing it. I'm sure you'll get it right.
Maybe. Timofev almost had a nice pass to Vigar. That's dumped in along the half boards. Chasing it down. There's Noah Little. Timofev not letting him have an inch. Timofev takes it center ice over the blue line. But he was denied, but he got a good rush there.
Nice stop by the number 1 for the Lynx, Igor Ignev. And if I say that enough times, Joe, I'm sure I get
it. Okay,
right.
I don't think their coach can pronounce it either. So, good guy, Matt Gaudette.
Like we said, I don't care how you do it or what you do, as long as you stop the puck.
That's right. Face off win by Lynx. They're trying to get out of their zone. And I think the net's off, Bill. It's I'm not an expert, but I think it's off.
It's definitely off.
Okay.
Joe, I was just looking out there, and I got a kind of a sparse crowd here tonight, and I guess the weather's something to
horrible,
do with it.
Yep.
It's cold, and I heard you had a bit of a snow blow there from Barry earlier in the day.
We did.
Day.
I had to dig it out before I can come, and as soon as I finish it, last scoop, good old snow plow covered me again, so I had to do it again.
I guess we're not all as fortunate as some little people that we know that get to go to Florida, Joe.
That's right. Kuchuk Yildiz gets it over the blue line. Lynx take control of it, try to get out of their zone. Playing a little ping pong down there as the Rattlers get it back. Over to Vlasic with a shot. Good save there. Broomberg throws it on the other side. The Lynx grab it. They go center ice. Over the blue line, there's a shot. Couldn't get a pass. Bapinchow again, giving his body up for the team, Bill.
Yeah, Bapinchow stayed right on that and Tuck blocked that shot.
Oh, he's all alone. Danger, danger. Will Robinson. Lund took care of that.
There's a nice shot by 63. And Lund made a nice stop there with just underneath the glove.
Looks like Hassan's going to go to the box. No? Yes? Maybe? No? Nope.
That was a real nice shot from Thomas Farrell. Come from a little town called Field, Ontario.
Ah.
So it's up north there a bit, and I'm sure they've seen a bit of snow there, Joe.
Well, at least he's not from the middle of Novar. There's a little place called Novar, in the middle of Novar. Vigar gets it up to Matt Barrett. Tended for Simpson. They're chasing it down. Simpson shot. Good save. He's a good little goaltender down there.
Yeah, he's getting lots of work.
Definitely is.
Definitely. This Lynx team, they were here once before, Joe.
Yes.
And they were pretty competitive and then...
rough and rugged.
Lost a bit of focus middle period there and put them behind the eight ball. And but then they came back. And so far... 1-1 here with about 7.5 minutes left to go in the first period.
Yeah, pretty even, Steven. Cameron to take the face off. Loses that one to the Lynx. Lynx trying to get into their zone. Rats putting on the pressure, though. 7:30 here left in the first. Shot. Lund again with a good save. Oh!
Yeah, Lund's he's a big body out there, and he covers the net well, but he does a real good job on covering his angles.
So we'll get a face-off. Blocker side of Lund. Cameron to take the face-off again. He wins that one, though. Vlasic chases it down, throws it along the other side for Simpson. Simpson gets it to Cameron. Cameron over the blue line gets it over to somebody that crossed Matt Barrett. Got a big hit there. That'll cause the turnover.
Yeah, I don't think Barrett was ready for that pass.
Uh-uh.
That was a nice little give and go there from 13 Neenan. And then Barrett got run over.
Got run over by a reindeer, a Rattler reindeer. Lynx trying to set it up. Wide of Lund. Vlasic with a good little hit there. Cameron gets it over to Vlasic. To Matt Barrett. Over the blue line now. Lynx foiled that plan. Some fresh legs on the ice for the Rats. Bapinchow. Up to Rezanowski. Rezanowski brings it over the blue line. Nice shot there. Bounce in front. Whoa, thrown down the other way. Looking at an icing call, Bill.
Yeah, it's going to be a nice and it was a nice rush by Rezanowski there. From end to end, just defenseman pushed him to the outside, and he didn't really get a real good shot away.
No. Comes a face-off. Risky took that face-off. Both teams struggling for it behind the net. Risky trying to hold on to it, keep it alive. But the Lynx take over. They bring it over the blue line. There's a shot. Good save by Lund. Here comes, does exist. Kept in. Rezanowski chasing it down. Now it gets to center ice where Dutraville finds it. He'll dump it in. The Lynx trying to get out of their zone. Lynx bring it center ice over the blue line. Nice pass there. Good shot, but good save by Lund, and he covers up to keep this a 1-1 hockey game with 4:52 left in the first.
First period's been a good back and forth, and both teams have stayed out of the box pretty well here, Joe.
Absolutely. Very disciplined first period for the most part. Dutraville take the face off. Loses that one to Lynx. There's a shot. Good save. Got the pad on it. Timo Feb picks it up. Hassan chasing it down. You like that when the goaltender plays that, Bill?
I love it. It's like the Mike Smith that plays for the Coyotes.
Yep.
It's your third defenseman out there.
Hassan. I think that shows absolute confidence. Or fear, depending on the goaltender. But most of the time, it's confidence.
Well, usually the fear comes into the coach's view when the goalie's out of the net and there's a scramble for the puck.
Oh! It wasn't pretty, but it got done.
There's a play that you don't see too often.
Nope.
What a nice play by 63 Farrell.
Yep.
Dump the puck in. Make sure the puck was going to rebound off the backboard and go back to him. Got the defenseman turned around and then took a swat at it and hit Lund on the top of the shoulder. And in it goes. And
it hit the post up top, and it just came down over the line.
Yeah, so that puts the Lynx up 2-1.
Indeed. We got ourselves a hockey game, Bill.
So two odd goals against Mr. London net there tonight, which is rare for him.
Yeah.
But I'm sure that we're getting near the end of the period. He'll right the ship in the second and third.
Oh, yeah. Over to Broomberg. Broomberg trying to set something up. In front, nobody home. Over to Muhammad. Shot. Taken care of. They're trying to set it back up. There's a shot. And it's in. And it's in, Bill. Tied it up. 2-2.
Didn't take the Rats long to get that back in.
Nope. Just true Rats style, Bill.
Yeah, that was it. I don't know what really happened there. It was kind of a rebound off the back wall, and then all of a sudden it's in the back of the net.
Indeed.
Well, I talked to the coaches before the game, and with Lund in net here, 35, and they got a lot of confidence in that young man, and that was an odd goal, and they just come right back and put him back tied 2-2 here.
That's what you want. You want your team behind you when that happens, and they're definitely there. In front, wide open net, nobody home. He was looking behind him to see if it went in the net. He didn't know where it was. Oh, here's a chance. Shot, good save.
Yeah, good shot by 91, Alex Gillette. Oh, there's going to be a penalty here. It's a cross-checking. It's going to go to number 10.
Simpson. And this is where most of the time they fall apart is the discipline, not the offense, defense, or goaltending. It's the discipline.
And you gotta just have discipline here. There's Lynx have got some momentum here late in the period. The Rats will have to. And there, that one just.
Broomberg got out of the way of that one.
Over the glass and into the Rattlers'
bench. There.
Bench.
Yep.
It's lucky that wasn't a delay of game, Joe, but it just touched the glass just before it went over the into the bench.
Yeah. Hassan trying to set something up here. Oh, there it is. A nice pass from Hassan.
That's just hard work by Hassan. It just outworked the Lynx player there. They dumped it in, and then he just outworked him getting to it.
I think that was Cameron, was it not?
It was. So,
Nealon?
Yeah, Nealon. Just Nealon's got the goal, but Hassan did all the work.
Yeah, and it was wide open. He really fooled that goaltender.
We've seen that quite a few times this year, Joe. The Rattlers shorthanded, scoring some shorthanded goals. And that's what it is, just putting pressure on that defense. And there's a penalty that's going to go to the Lynx for, I believe, tripping.
Yep, you called it, Bill.
Stuck his leg out there and upset. So 98's going to the box.
Nick Gribbins, that's the second time he's in the box tonight.
Nick Gribbins from North Bay. This is only his seventh game, I believe. So they're telling me in the program here, Joe.
Oh.
So we're going to play 4-on-4 here.
For a little bit, anyway. Coming up to 2 minutes left here in the first period, 3-2 Rattlers. Good save there. Seems you come right at this boy, he's going to save it. But if you get it tic-tac-toe, then he's got a little trouble.
Well, yeah, he's a big body there. He comes out and covers the angles really well. But the couple goals they've got on him, you're right, from side to side, getting him to going. And he hasn't just got across there quick enough to save them.
Broomberg keeping it alive. Put it in front. Nobody home. Ruslan, I'll chase it down. Cover it up. Keep this a 3-2 hockey game.
Got about a minute, 44 seconds left to go here, Joe, in the first period. Rattlers up 3-2 from
Absolutely.
That shorthanded goal.
Here come the Lynx. Broomberg foiled that. Gets it over to Hassan. Hassan over to Timo Fev over the blue line. Over to Broomberg, intended for. Got away from him. He'll have to dump that in. Hassan trying to keep it alive there. Lynx putting on the pressure, though. Trying to get out of their zone. 1:04 left, just about the last minute of play here in the first. 3-2 Rattlers. High sticking's the call, Bill.
Yeah, there's a high stick. And they're not happy about it. It's going to be, looks like Timofab's going for high sticking. So we're going to see 4-on-3 here for a short period of time.
Absolutely. Face-off win by the Rattlers, but pressure's on. Under a minute of play here in the first. 3-2 Rattlers. Hassan's got it. Center ice over the blue line. Attempted pass at Muhammad Kuchuk Yildiz. He has to work for it. Here come the Lynx. 42 seconds left. There's a shot. Good save. Garbage cleaned up by... Oh, he'll have to cover up as it popped back in front of him. Lund playing it safe there, Bill.
Yeah, he's doing a good job there. That was a nice pad save. Kicked that into the corner. Then it took a funny bounce. Come right back out to him.
Now we got 33.8 seconds left. 3-2 Rattlers. Now we're still, what, 4-on-4?
4-on-4 here. And
12 seconds, looks like.
And then the Lynx will go on a 5-on-4. Lund got a little lucky there,
he
Joe.
Got very lucky. Over to Cameron, over the blue line. 23 seconds left. Cameron takes a shot. Chipped in. Good save there. Ruslan. Trying to slow it down, set it up with 11 seconds left. Try to get it to Cameron. Cameron gets some resistance there, but he keeps a hold of it. Lynx take it over, try to get out of their zone. That's it, Bill, for the the first period. We'll see them in the second.
All right, Joe. That was a pretty good period.
Absolutely. See you soon. welcome back for a second period of action. Timo Fev in the box for 56 more seconds. And it's 3-2 your Rattlers. So let's see what happens here. Tied up. Lynx come away with it. Opening faceoff goes to the Lynx. Lynx bring it over the blue line. Have to regroup center ice. Lynx bring it over the blue line again. Take a shot. It's wide of the net. They keep possession of it, but the Rattlers putting on the pressure. Rattlers have it now. They dump it up the ice with 22 seconds left in the penalty to number 22, Timo Fev. Lynx trying to get out of their zone. They get it center ice, but Ruslan sees that, throws it the other way. 4 seconds left, and Timo Fev will be back on for an even 5-on-5. Here we go. 19 minutes left in the second period. 3-2 Rattlers. And we are all even 5-5 as the penalty comes to an end. Here's Cameron trying to do something with it here, center ice. Gets it to Ruslan. Ruslan chips it up the ice. Lynx find it in their zone. They get it center ice over the blue line. Noah Little trying to take care of business there. Lund had to help out, and he saved that. And a good save at that. Nice hard shot. But a tight save. Face off. Cameron wins that one. Gets it to Noah Little. Along the half boards to Hassan. Hassan over to Timo Fev. Timo Fev gets it over the blue line. It's a 2-on-1. Good pass. Ooh, just off target by Cameron. The net was off, but they fixed it in time. Lynx bring it over the blue line. Noah Little foiling his plans there. Hassan gets it over to Timo Fev. Timo Fev over to Cameron. Cameron throws it in along the half boards.
That's okay.
Timo Fev picks it up. Shot by Simpson. Couldn't get it through the bodies. It finally got through. Covered up by Ignatov. Pretty good save there, Bill.
Yeah, real nice save by Ignatov. He had lots of work in that first period. The Rats outshot the Lynx 14-13 in the first period.
Absolutely. And it's been pretty one-sided. The Rattlers taking most of the shots this period. It's about 3-1. Broomberg trying to do something with it here. There's up 3-2, but could use that insurance goal that was a little off the target with the pass. Bappenchow gets it over to Simpson, center ice. Simpson. Over to Vigar. Vigar couldn't get a shot off. Bappenchow keeping it alive. 17-10 left here in the second period. 3-2 is the score. The Lynx take over that center ice, bring it over the blue line. There's a shot. Good save, Lund. Garbage cleaned up. Another shot. In front. Little danger, danger, Will Robinson there. There's a a big opportunity there. They got to get it out, Bill.
Yeah, they got Lund made two or three nice saves there, but they got him scrambling around down low there.
That's when you got to get it out to give him a chance to get back in position there, Bill. Throwing up the ice to Mohamed Kuchuk-Yildiz over the blue line. Good pass to Broomberg. Fakes the shot. Oh, couldn't get a shot off, but it looked nice.
He did so. He
looked like he had control, Bill.
He did so. He had that goalie's kind of flat-footed there. He didn't know what he was going to do. But
like a crossover in basketball.
He did so, but he unfortunately couldn't pull the trigger.
That's right. Otherwise, that would have been a goal for sure.
Had a good interview between the periods there with Chris Russo, one of the referees for the GMHL.
For the show Inside the GMHL. You'll be seeing that Tuesday. Noah Little gets it over to Rezanowski. He's get picked off by Farrell. Wow, some nice pass in there. I don't think they meant to, but here's a chance. Couldn't get the shot off. A delayed penalty, Bill.
Going to be a hooking call here.
Illegal on and off the ice, as I understand, Bill.
Yeah, I think that's how it goes in the rule books.
Absolutely. Read it once.
So number five, going to the penalty box. Ruslan, how do you say that, Joe?
Ruslan, number five, Ruslan Moskivitin. I don't
know.
That's why I just call him Ruslan.
You go into the box for 2 minutes for hooking.
Not good. Not good. Second power play of the period. They had about 53 seconds left in their power play when we started this period. And now they got a full 2 minutes. We'll see how that goes. Dump down the ice.
Like I said, if you're going to dump that puck in, Joe, you got to get it deep.
Absolutely. There's a shot. Wide of the net, just off target. A minute 10 left in the penalty to Ruslan. 15 minutes left in the period.
Yeah, not much of a... Matt Barrett there had a good opportunity to clear the puck. There's a nice save by Lund, directing that puck into the corner.
Got the pad on it.
It's one thing about the goalies is they, with their experience and they, with these shots, Joe, they can direct the puck into certain areas of the corners or where they want to.
If they're on their game, for sure, and Lund's definitely on there. That goes the penalty's got 37 seconds left in it. They looked a little excited there that it was happening. Yeah. Ending now, but...
Yeah, I'm not sure what that goalie was doing for the Lynx. Usually the goalie taps the ice to let the team know that the penalty's almost over, but there's still like 25 seconds left.
I think it was Ruslan's fault. He looks like he's ready to jump out of the box now, and he's got 17 seconds left. Here come the Lynx on the attack. Pass in front, good pass, but the shot couldn't get on target, but a really good opportunity.
Papenchel made a nice play there, got down and didn't give him an opportunity to have a clean shot at the net.
Ruslan came out flying. That'll kill it. That's even 5-on-5 now. A 68, he's playing pretty well there. Braden Simpson from Warren, Ontario.
68, Joe, I'm not sure in my book. Lawson Yelowoskoski from Geraldton, Ontario.
I guess we'll go with yours. It's the most recent there. All right, fair enough.
Yeah, he's been the most dominant player for the Lynx out here so far.
Yep. There's a whistle, Bill. What do we got going on?
I'm not sure what to call an offside here, Joe. Yes.
Offside, okay. I thought it was the song "Stop in the Name of Love." Just the hand action he had.
Well, that's pretty good, Joe. You got any Christmas carols in there?
No, that's Kevin Dutraville live on his Facebook doing Christmas carols. I'll have to check that out.
Oh, so he's got many talents. Young man, he can play defense, play forward, and he can sing.
Yeah, absolutely.
And he's playing forward here tonight. Looks like.
Yeah, and where he belongs, in my opinion. Good pass there, but it got in the wrong hands. Well, on the wrong stick, at least.
Almost too many men there, Joe. Lynx player just jumped back into the box there. Nick of time, or it'd have been too many men on the ice.
That would not have been good. They come over the blue line, but foiled by Michael Fanakis. The Lynx coach actually played in the GMHL for the Lumberjacks before they were the Nippising Lynx.
Played for the
and Alouettes.
Sturgeon Falls, yep. The Lumberjacks.
Yep. And the Alouettes.
I believe one year they won the championship, Joe.
They did, but he wasn't on the team for that one, I don't think. But they definitely did. Whoop, good opportunity there. Good cover up by Ignatov.
Yeah, I remember the Lumberjacks when they played there, and they had quite the uniforms.
Were they
black and white?
They weren't checkered.
Yeah, they were checkered.
Oh, they were.
They had like checkered coats. They had a big team that year too. There's a nice shot and a nice goal by number 13,
there it is.
The man from San Jose Sharks,
Cameron Nealon.
I believe that's his second goal of the night.
I believe that's called an insurance goal, Bill, because even if they get one, they'll still be up.
Yeah, 4-2. It was nice. Nice shot from the slot there. Rebounded. That young man was right on there and popped it in. He's been a nice little addition here, Joe. I was talking to him, and he's, like I said, playing in San Jose there for the U18 team, and wanted to change the scenery and pick the Bradford Rattlers.
And that's when you know a quality player, when he can fit in like he's been on the team the whole year. The only thing I think he's regretting is the weather.
Well, I'm not sure.
I'm not sure.
Well, if we get an opportunity, we'll speak to him about the weather. And there's another nice shot of his.
Yeah.
We've seen him a couple times here, Joe. He's got a lot of jump.
Oh, for sure. I think it'll be a short stop for him here in the G. He'll be moving on up. But
yeah.
You can never tell, but... if anybody would, I think it'd be him for
There's
sure.
There's a nice save by Lund again.
Lynx not giving up?
No, not at all. Down 4-2, but there's no give. They're putting some pressure on here in this zone.
Here comes Timo Fab. Oh, what do we got there, Bill?
Hand pass, and it'll go back into the Rattlers' end.
Timo Fab. Thinks it was hit off the leg, but those blues know what they're doing, or those black and whites.
The man in the stripes there, I think they got the right call. Got pretty experienced two referees here and a linesman out here tonight, which is nice to see when you get two clubs here and letting them play.
Yep. 10:41 left in the second, 4-2 Rattlers. Along the boards, Timo Fev finds it on the other end. Try to get it up to Cameron. Foiled, but Hassan has it. Picked off again by that 68 we're seeing.
Definitely so. Like I said, he's got the jump on this team here, and there's a nice save by Ignatov.
Great shot.
Ignatov.
That was pretty much one-on-one, him and the goaltender. Grunberg and the goaltender.
Yeah, Ignatov would come out there and almost the top of the crease there and didn't give him much to shoot at.
Simpson take the face off. He wins that one, or ties it up, sorry. And then he picks it up. Tried to keep it in Ruslan, but he needed to grow a few inches. Rezanowski. It's tied up there. Both teams trying to get possession of it. Rezanowski comes up with it over the blue line. Some nice moves there. No shot, though. There it is. Simpson puts it in, but they pretty much... set it up for Simpson, putting him on the ground.
Yeah, that's second or third time that Ignef has got caught out of the net and flat-footed. And again, got caught out there and then got flat-footed and on his back. And Simpson didn't have much problem finding the empty net there.
So we're going to get some more insurance there. That's 5-2 now. 9:53 left in the second, Bill.
Yeah, I mean, I'm surprised at looking down the bench here. We don't see Wah coming out here.
Yeah.
Because the team has kept them in the game, but those last couple goals and that young man in net's been a little shaky.
It seems the Rattlers have his number and know how to shake him up.
Yeah, a bit of a, like you said, a bit of a stutter step there and caught him flat-footed. Last couple goals here.
So when that's happening, they've got the better of them. We need to maybe switch them up, but I'm sure that Matt's got some experience in the GMHL. He'll take care of it. Rezanowski trying to set it up here. Brisky shot.
There's a delayed penalty, Joe.
Yep. It's going to go to the Lynx, it looks like.
Lynx there's for a slash. Number 7's going to the box.
I've got Sergei Koroshin. Is that what you got, Bill?
That's what I got.
Okay, good. We're on the same page now.
Sergei Horshin from Saratov, Russia.
Kachuk Yildiz, he'll throw that for himself. Setting it up. Pass at the point to Timo Fev. Shot. Good save. The rebound. Couldn't get the second shot off, so they'll try to set up again. Timo Fev has it up top. Gets it over to Broomberg. Takes a good shot. Good save there. Cameron trying to set it up. Gets it over to Hassan. Over to Timo Fev. Picked off by the Lynx, and they might go on a breakaway, but Timo Fev and Hassan coming back with some speed to deny that breakaway. He's got a shot off, but that's no good. Did you see the speed them coming back?
Did so, and that's why they're on this team, and that's why they've got as many points as they do.
Absolutely.
Nice back check by them.
Oh,
there's a nice little play.
Deflection there.
Yeah, I'm not sure that would have counted, Joe.
No.
Timonoff, he kind of just directed that with a skate, but...
I don't think it was on purpose, but yeah.
Not sure. He's pretty handy.
Oh, what a goal by Cameron.
There it is.
My gosh, is that the trick?
That's the trick.
Where's the hats, home team?
Yeah, and here they come with the Waz coming.
They're throwing it. The players are throwing it.
And I'm sure.
They're throwing the toques. Toss it. Toss it.
Yeah, the number 3, that was a nice goal.
Yeah.
And there's a goalie change. We're going to go with
I think it's time. We got Wah. I'm saying Wah. I got permission.
Justin Wah is coming in.
He said either way works. He's trying to find his hat because he threw it.
Don't think it made the ice, Joe.
No, it didn't make the ice. And I don't think he knew where it made it because he's still looking for it.
So that was the hat trick for number 13.
Yeah, Cameron Nealon.
From Newark, California. And he's been a... I talked to the general manager there today, Sean Worth, and how they got this young man and won an opportunity to play outside of California. And he's also had a couple buddies here also playing for the Rattlers, which made it transition a little easier.
It's really shown you how far in the 11 seasons the GMHL has come, that these caliber of players are jumping on board.
Well, again, what you look at the Rattlers organization here, and every year they're one of the top 2 or 3 teams in the league. And consistency, good organization, and wants somebody to come and play here.
In 2012-2013 season, they went 42-0-0.
Absolutely. They were quite a dominant team.
Another shot. There's good nice save fish. There by Wah.
Well, yeah, just starting out and made a nice save.
The only thing would better for Justin Wah would be if his middle name was Patrick. Then I wouldn't call him Justin. I'd call him Patrick Wah with the save.
There's a nice check along the boards. Neutraville got drilled into the boards there, but he's a tough young man. He's back up and at it.
Here comes the Lynx. Nice pass there. And they earned that goal, Bill. They earned that goal.
You bet.
What was that, 98?
Nice pass from 98
Nick
up.
Nick Scrivens. They earned that. That was pretty. That was beautiful. I have to say.
Yeah, that was a nice stretch pass. He cut 98 cuts, I believe number. Not sure what number that was scored there, Joe. We'll wait for the announcement. Lund got caught in the back of the net a little bit there, and he roofed it right over the top of him.
Yep. But, again, they have the insurance. It's 6-3. Risky with a little physical action there.
Yeah, you'd like to see the Rattlers be a little more physical here again. because as they get into the playoffs here, that's something that they're going to have to do to compete.
Well, I was talking to the coach, Matt Gaudette from the Lynx. They weren't expecting how physical they'd be, and it kind of threw them off. But now they're understanding that they're going to be physical, and they got to counteract. And they proved that with a hit on Dutroville.
Absolutely.
Rezanowski over to Simpson. Simpson already with a goal tonight. Back to Rezanowski. Back to Simpson. Brisky with a nice shot there, but it was taken care of by Waugh. And we have a whistle there, Bill.
Yeah, what's I'm not sure, on? But I wouldn't doubt if what happened there is...
Number six going to the box, looks
yeah,
like.
He hooked, yeah, he had to hook his man there, or he was going to have a direct line to the net. He had
Devin Velket.
A lot of pressure there by the
wrong
Rattlers
box.
In that.
Wrong box. Six. Devin Velket. Velket.
Devin Velket.
Velket.
From Blind River. He's going to the penalty box for hooking.
Broomberg back to Muhammad. Oh, nice pass to Timo Fev. Nice pass.
Oh, they're looking for that cross
they
ice
are.
Pass again.
They like it.
It's too. And Timo Fev had the opportunity to shoot there, Joe, and they stuck with the system. Went down low and the cross ice pass. It just didn't get there.
We talk about Timo Fev all the time and the control he has with himself. That shows real control. A lot of players would have shot that and not stuck to the system. But Timo Fev has that control, that presence, the presence of mind on the ice. He's so good. He's so good.
Well, there's no doubt they miss him when he's not there.
Oh, for sure. Nah, another one. Broberg knows his spot.
Again, Timo Fev waited, threaded that through two or three guys right onto Broberg, and Broberg had nothing but net. Again, Joe, like we said, those defensemen, those forwards, they got to get down there, and they can't let that pass come across there.
No, it's dangerous. Danger, danger, Will Robinson.
Joe, you know, I looked up in Google, looked in that
Google, how?
That Google book, and looked for Will Robinson.
Didn't and find him?
No.
Shot, good save by Waugh. Waugh decides to cover up, play it safe. Keeping it 7-3 with 4:26 left in the second.
You'd wonder if these coaches that come down here, Joe, they don't look a bit of replays, and they get an opportunity. They can go on the G and watch the games from the Rattlers and watch how that power play set up. So when they get here, and I guess it's easier said than done.
Oh, for
but
sure.
Again, every team that comes in here, they can't seem to stop that setup.
Almost every team, yeah. A lot of shorthanded goals this year.
And, you know, every team has the opportunity to watch the Rattlers game replays and while also watching them live here, Joe.
Yep. I know I'd be watching. Here comes Lynx with a nice shot. Good hard shot. Good save by Lund. Broomberg trying to get out of the Rattlers zone. He chips it up the ice. He's still got the penalty on the board, but he's out of the box, right?
There's a goal that
there it is.
I'm number eight. And Lund, I'm sure he'd like to have that one back.
Yeah, I was missing it because I'm seeing a countdown on the board, Bill, for a penalty, but I'm pretty sure he came out of the box.
Yeah, there's nobody in the box there, and Lund hasn't looked sharp here tonight, Joe. Not his record. He's 8-2. That one right off his blocker in into the net. Ivan Sirkovsk. He's 25 games with the Lynx, 8 goals, 11 assists.
Rattlers trying to get it out. Kept in by the Lynx. Stewart sends it in. Preston Kopp has it center ice. Gets it to A1. A1, nice move there. Shot. Good save by Waugh, but that was a nice move by A1.
Yeah, a lot of the Rats were crashing the net pretty good there, but Watt, come on, cut that angle off.
Along the boards. Lynx trying to get out of their zone. Vlasic, good shot, good save by Waugh. Waugh with a save.
Yeah, number six there. He got tangled up in his own skates there and give the Rattlers an opportunity to get a shot on Waugh, but he's seen quite a bit of work from coming in here.
Nice shot by Rezanowski, but a good save. Or it's just off target, sorry. But Waugh looked ready, sprawled out. In front. Covered up by Waugh. Justin Waugh with the save.
You know, we talked about that between the periods, Joe, with the referees, and you and I talked about it as the Lynx were here the last time, the same thing. They were competitive, and then all of a sudden they hit a flat spot for
it's true.
4 or 5 minutes and took themselves out of the game. Not 100%. That it's not over, but
nope.
Playing a team like the Rattlers, you can't be down by 3 or 4 goals here and,
nope.
and get back in it.
Rezanowski over the blue line. Shot got deflected. Right place at the right time for number 16. Another opportunity in front of the net. Again, Rezanowski controlling that goaltender, even though it's a different goaltender this time. Net off?
Net off, and I'm not sure referees, even though the net come off, they're going to take that face off outside. I think he thought number 10, Simpson, caused the net to come off the moorings.
Happens. Shot, good save by Lund. Simpson chipping up the Rezanowski. Rezanowski gets a little help there from Noah Little. Over to Brisky. Brisky dropping it back for Simpson. Simpson, little tap there for Vigar. Now the Lynx take it over, bring it center ice. We got a whistle, Bill. What's the call?
It's going to be a slash here. Boy, we talked about it in the first period, Joe, how the teams are staying out of the box, but there's been a run to it right now. And number 18,
Rezanowski.
Rezanowski's going to the box for slashing. So the Lynx, with a minute and 38 seconds here left to go in the period, down 7-4, can make it 7-5 and be back in this game for the third period.
And they could do it the way they've been playing.
But again, the Rattlers with a couple of shorthanded goals here, so they want to make sure they don't make it 8-4.
That's right. Here comes Cameron Artie with a hat trick tonight over the blue line. Nice pass to Matt Barrett. Couldn't get the shot off, though. Waugh plays out along the boards.
Nealon's showing some nice speed in the outside there. Barrett just couldn't get to the net.
Muhammad. Tied up on the boards.
Tie, Joe. When you talk about tie, this must be a no tie night, is it?
I guess. For who? For what? The bench? Oh, for
Nathan Kennedy? No tie tonight?
I put one on. Oh, they tipped it in there, Bill!
Nice tip in there. And like I said, made it 7-5. With 33 seconds left here in the period. So if they can hang on here, come back into the third period, only down by 2.
That's the way you do it. That's the way you do it.
Number 91, Alex Gallette, with his 8th goal of the season. So the Lynx are not out of it, Joe. Like we said, they're never out of it.
Nope.
It's just... In this league, you just can't have a 4 or 5 minute lapse.
24 seconds left here in the second. 7-5 is the score. Broomberg gets over to Hassan. Over to Broomberg. Pass in front. Couldn't capitalize. Hassan trying to keep it alive. 8 seconds left. Mohamed Kuchuk Yildiz. There it is. That's the period. We'll be even 5-on-5, 7-5 going into the third, Bill.
Yeah, it'll be a good third period here, Joe.
All right, we'll be back with you.
I'm seeing the Lynx going to come out hard here in the next period.
Thank you. biggest boss and I've been the trillest. I'm a bigger problem when I click with Skrillex. Murder on my mind, it's time to pray to God. My revolver's not religious, the revolution's born. You wanna know my name, then go and tell us all. You wanna know my gang, Suicide Squad. Killers everywhere, it ain't no place to run. Forgive me for my wrongs, I have just begun. Ain't no mercy, ain't no mercy. Got that purple Lamborghini lurking. Ain't no mercy, ain't no mercy. Got that purple Lamborghini lurking. Rosé! Don't be begging for your life, cause that's a lost cause. High stakes, body armor, suicide boy. It's the time for games and it's the time to kill. Make up your mind, baby, cause the time is here. Ain't no mercy, ain't no mercy. Got that purple Lamborghini lurking. Ain't no mercy, ain't no mercy. Got that purple Lamborghini lurking. Rosé!
Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we're back for the last period. 7-5 is the score. We'll see how it goes here. Both teams showing their support from the bench. Bill Fiennes is back with us.
Good to be back in this period. This should be a good period here, Joe.
Yeah.
Had a couple of good interviews there. Talked to a few of the Lynx players.
Yeah.
And
you know what, Bill?
They've got a couple new bodies out there, like they said. Here's good save by Lund there.
The last Rattlers game of the year. I'm not going to see it till next year, buddy.
That's a long time, Joe.
Yeah.
That'll be 217.
That's right. Cameron with a hat trick. Wins that face-off. Bappin Chow not happy with himself. He's been on the ice for a lot of those goals, and he's just taking it personally, Bill, but I don't think he should. He's been doing well.
He just come back off. He hasn't played. I'm off injury there.
He's being too hard on himself.
There's a nice goal.
There's a goal. But he's being too hard on himself, Bill.
Yep. There's another goal set up by number 13. I'm not sure who scored that one.
But that'll help the plus-minus for Bappin Chow.
Absolutely.
Atta boy. Lund looking sharp after.
Another goal by Broomberg there, but the good work again down low by number 13.
Yep. Simpson to take the face-off. It's bounced around. Simpson wins that one. Matt Barrett dumping it in.
Cameron Nguyen has made a very good impression here, Joe.
Huge.
We seen that in the first game he played here with a lot of jump.
Oh, yeah. Like he played the whole season. I keep saying it, but it's so true. Mohamed Kuchuk-Yildiz took care of that turnover.
Well, that's not the start the Lynx wanted to come out of the box. But, again, there's...
No, a little looked like a little hurt there behind the knee.
Number 68's going to the penalty box for the Lynx.
Mine's wrong, I think, so I'll let you tell me who it is.
Lawson Yaskolowski.
What he said.
That's what I said.
That is what you said.
Yaskolowski. Lawson Yaskolowski, and I finally got it, Joe.
Bless
Took
you.
A little bit. But like I said, this is not the start the Lynx wanted here.
No.
They're only down by two. Now they're down by three, and the Rats going on a power play.
They're dangerous on the shorthanded. Imagine how they are in the power play. Broomberg trying to set it up. Gets it over to Hassan. Picked off. The Lynx trying to make up for it. Good blocker save there, Bill.
Yes. Lund's come out a little so far. Been on his game here the last couple saves.
Well, how he does it, he was in the hallway trying to get in the zone, getting centered, and it seemed to have worked a little bit there. Even his teammates were coming up to him. He says, no, please don't bother me. I'm trying to focus here.
Yeah, at number 13 there, Nealon, he got run over there in the back there, Joe, and Rattler's going in to talk to the referee about it.
Oh, I don't think the ref's going to do anything, though.
So, Joe, have you been talking to Nathan lately about what's going to happen here for Christmas and what kind of a Christmas gift we're going to get from the Big M?
From the Big M? Not yet. I haven't spoke to him yet.
I've mentioned fish fillet and fries is one of my favorites.
Oh, fish fillet is my favorite.
When I do eat there. Being the athletic type, you know, I try to stay away from that.
I'm his cousin. He doesn't even give me a discount. Oh, wow. Here come the Lynx trying to do something here, but they were foiled. Broomberg getting in the way of that as he almost set it up in front. Timo Fev over to Hassan. Get it center ice. Over the blue line. Over to Muhammad Kuchuk-Yildiz. Drops it back for Broomberg. Lynx putting on the pressure, though, Bill.
Yeah, they got to force it, Joe. They can't. They've watched the Rats here too much move that puck around. So the only way to spoil that is you got to put pressure on them. But you can't have any flybys, and I'm not sure what a couple of them are doing out here right at the moment.
Timo Fav showed some nice moves there, but lost control of it. Penalty's coming to an end. Lund letting them know. That'll be it. They're even 5-on-5 now, Bill.
Yeah, it's Broomberg again. A shot just went wide up top of the net.
Pass in front. Nobody home. Timo Feb picks it up. Keeping it alive. He'll take a shot. Trickles away to the side. Hassan. Over to Muhammad Kuchuk-Yildiz. Over to Broomberg. To Muhammad. Picked off by the Lynx. Broomberg chipped it into the box.
Joe, I thought after talking to a couple of those players from the Lynx there that they'd have some jump coming out here in this third period, but...
More of a slump.
Boy, that's like I said, they went in that 3 or 4 minute funk, and they got to get out of it here. Like, they're only down by three.
Well, they have a catering table, and maybe they ate too many oranges and bananas and some bread.
Well, you know, that's usually not the problem. Those are the things that restore the energy.
Oh, that's true. Matt Barrett had an opportunity there, couldn't capitalize. Simpson putting on the pressure as the Lynx try to get it out. There's a whistle.
Passed, hand pass and blown down by the officials. So, Joe, we're going to pick this up, start of the first of the year again, and then we're going to make a trip to Tilsonburg, I believe, on the 10th of January.
Yeah, I'll
for
pick
the
you
All-Star
up.
Game. You're going to pick me up?
In the limo.
In the limo?
Yep.
I thought
the red
maybe,
2008 Dodge Caravan.
Oh, what
limo.
A nice save by Lund there. He just snapped that one out of the air.
Yep.
He's a little sharper this period. You know, goalies, Joe, it's a lot of it is mental.
Oh, yeah. Would you say almost 80-20?
Yeah, it's when they're on, but they're usually goalies take it upon themselves the worst way.
Yep. Nice pass in front. Good save by Lund.
Another nice setup.
Again, the Lynx not giving up. Maybe they're shaking off that little slump at the beginning.
Number 91, Alex Gillette, one of our interviews, made a nice pass out there to 68. But
now he's going to the box.
Both of them are going, both of them are going to the box here, Joe. Both 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct here.
Refs are going to make they're going to get coal in their stocking, Bill.
Well, they're going to make sure that this. They've got a couple of experienced referees here, and they're going to make sure this doesn't get out of hand. So we're going to play 4-on-4, and I'm not sure who that gives that advantage to.
Ruslan. Ruslan fell down, but he made a good play there to get it back over to his player.
Yeah, you know that they say that invisible man checked him there, Joe.
He did. Took him out. Here come the Lynx, bring it center ice. Preston Kopp had a different idea there, keeping it alive. Thrown down the ice. Icing may
be the
call.
Gonna be an icing call here against the Lynx.
There we go.
Like I said, I'm not sure who the advantage goes to here, 4-on-4, but the Lynx have got a couple talented young men there also that we've seen. This Lawson Yakososki has got some moves, and number 98 also.
Yeah. Vigar shot wide of the net. Hassan sees it on the other side.
Nick Gibbons, number 98.
Yeah. 110 left in the penalties. Here come the Lynx. Bap and Chow. Oh, the goal.
Nice move by number 7. Just come across there and cut into Sergei Horoshkin. Just waited and waited till he got Lund pulled over and then buried one right over his shoulder. So it's now 8-6.
Bapenchow really taking it personally. He's got to realize that was just a good play.
It was, but again, not sure Mr. Lund here tonight. They've caught him in the back of the net quite a few times there. And a big body like himself needs to stay out and top of that crease. But again, it's easier said up than here done. Than down there, Joe. Indeed.
Yep. Hat trick, Mr. Cameron there, Nealon. Broomberg over the blue line. In front for Ruslan. A little weak backhander there, took him care easily by Waugh. And Waugh covered up to keep this an 8-6 hockey game there, Bill.
Yeah, the Rattlers have been buzzing around Waugh down there, but they haven't showed many shots for it. I think that's only their third shot of the period.
Yeah. Cameron to take the face off. 31 seconds left in the penalties. Lynx win that. They get it center ice over the blue line. Vigar picks it off, though. He gets it center ice over to Broomberg over the blue line. Pass in front. Nobody home. Cameron trying to keep it alive. Gets it to Vigar. Couple shots there. Couldn't get through the bodies. Cameron throwing it behind the net. The Lynx will pick that up. Get out of their zone. There goes the penalties. We're 5-on-5 now, Bill. Farrell. Nice backhander.
Farrell made a nice backhand move there, and Lund had lost it for a second. There's another shot on Lund from the point.
Luckily, his teammates took care of the garbage, though, and got it out.
The Lynx have got a bit of jump back in their step here, Joe.
They do. They do. Couldn't get the shot through the bodies.
Nice block by Bapenchow there.
Yep. See, he's not giving himself enough credit. He's playing well. Simpson with it. Artie with a goal tonight. Over the blue line. Chips it in front. The Lynx pick it up. Chipped into the corner. And by John Stewart. Matt Barrett sends it center ice to Simpson. Simpson over the blue line. Now the Lynx take control of it with 11:55 left here in the third period, 8-6 Rattlers. Still anybody's game with plenty of time left, Bill.
Yeah, there's still lots of time here. I'm sure there's going to be a few more goals scored also.
Oh, absolutely. Rezanowski trying to get it out. Gets it to center ice. Over to Matt Barrett. Drops it back for Simpson. Simpson gets a little resistance. Here come the Lynx on the attack. They get it over the blue line. Nice pass to himself. That was just pretty. He just off the target.
Nice move by Sergei Horshin. Again, there it, through the legs there. It just flipped it.
Oh. Hassan with a good opportunity, just couldn't capitalize.
Yeah, nice breakaway there and just couldn't bury it.
Calling off the icing, Bill. Lynx trying to get it out. They get it center ice, picked off by Hassan. Hassan seems to play better with Broomberg and... Timofev on the ice.
Well, there's no doubt when you're playing with good players, they make...
rise to the occasion.
Absolutely, and they open up some space, so give a little more room to move the puck around.
Indeed.
But the sign of a good player, Joe, is a player that can play with anybody that's put on either side of him. And you'll see that from Timofev. He makes the players good on either side. Exactly. Makes players good on each side of him. That's a sign of a good hockey player.
Yep. Bapp and Chow, center ice, throws it over the blue line. Cameron and Simpson putting on the pressure. It gets across the blue line. Bapp and Chow chase it down, but no need as Lund covers up to keep it an 8-6 hockey game with 10:20 left in the third, Bill.
Yeah, like you said, the Lynx had a little lapse there just at the start of the period, but the last 5 or 6 minutes here... they've had even or maybe a little better than the play.
There's a shot. Another, good save.
Nice off the face-off, and Farrell got a nice shot away. Lund come out. Like I said, that big body was at the top of this crease there and didn't give him anything to shoot at.
Face-off win by Cameron. Gets it to Vlasic. Vlasic along the half-boards to Broomberg. Broomberg sent in at center ice. Couldn't capitalize on it. Bapp and Chow helping out. Broomberg gets it over the blue line to Simpson. Simpson over to Broomberg. Couldn't hold on to it, though. Here come the Lynx. Over the blue line. Picked off by Noah Little, but he gets it to Cameron. Cameron brings it over the blue line. Nice move there.
Nice move by number 19 there, Joe. Brendan Villeneuve from North Bay for the Lynx. They've got some speed down the middle here.
They do. He'll cover up to keep that safe as two black and yeller were coming down the Chicago line.
Absolutely, with a 9:32 here to go in the third, 8-6. Like I said, the Lynx look good here. They've got some speed down the middle. Had a little difficulty for a couple minutes in each period here.
How tough is it, Bill, for to be the Lone Ranger on the bench as a coach?
Well, it's difficult, believe me. You're the man making the changes from the defensive and the offensive end and side and trying to see what's going on. Usually you have a couple assistants with you down there to even make those line changes.
Yeah, I know. I was on my own on the inside the GMHL last week, and I fell out of my element for sure.
Joe, yeah, but being a professional is experience, and I'm sure that young man on the bench, he's got a little experience, but having an extra body down there for line changes, like I said, and just watch what's going on in the game, makes a big difference.
Four eyes, six eyes are always better than two. Vigar trying to get it out. Matt Brett tying it up on the boards. Vigar comes away with it. Brings it center ice. Over the blue line. Avoids a big hit there. Just walks in like he owns the place, but Watt took care of that.
He did so. He made a nice there. And, Joe, one of the things, too, is when you're coaching is that you're coaching or watching the game, and you'll see some coaches, they're just watching the game. They're not really seeing what's really going on in the game. And that's why you got to have some experience on the bench like the Rattlers do, watching the game and watching what's going on out there, making adjustments during the game.
Well, they got three coaches out there. Well, the GM, the coach, and the assistant coach. There's an icing. And then they got the trainer there keeping an eye on things, making sure everybody's safe too, I guess.
Absolutely.
Lots of eyes on the Rattlers bench.
And again, saying that too, having some experience on the with the players makes a big difference too. Guys that have played some hockey and played at this level or even
beyond
this.
Vlasic keeping it alive along the half boards. Almost got to Broomberg. Lynx trying to get it out. They get it center ice. Noah Little chips that up the ice. Making the Lynx regroup. What do we, 7:49 left in the third, 8-6. Lund chipped that aside. Got a piece of it. Mohamed Kuchuk-Yildiz trying to get it out.
Nice play there. Noah Little stuck right to his man there and didn't give him any opportunity to move.
Broomberg trying to get it out with Brisky. Brisky picked off. Kept alive. Danger. Good save by Lund.
Not a good play by Brisky there, trying to drag that puck out on his own and turned it over right at the top at the blue line. What happens there, Joe, is you get the other forwards leaving the zone thinking you're going to get out, and all of a sudden there's a turnover and you got turn it onto a 3-on-2 or a 4-on-2 going the other way.
And that's where mistakes happen and games get lost, even if you're up. Cameron wins that face-off. Rappin' Chow. Over to Cameron. Cameron over to Vigar, over to Hassan, over the blue line. Try to get the pass off. Lynx had another idea. But Bappin Chow keeping it alive. Dumps it in. Hassan chasing it down. Vigar keeping it alive. Dumping it in. That's just killing some seconds on the clock there. Lynx not letting them set anything up. But definitely the Rattlers not letting them go on the offense either. But now they get it center ice. They throw it in. Vigar finds it on the other end. Chips it up to Hassan. Song gets picked off. He gets another chance at it. Tried to get it to Cameron. It got away from him. That'll go down the other way. Banged off the glass. Kept alive by Vigar. Over to Hassan. Hassan sees Timofev in front. He's trying to set it up. Gets it over to Hassan. In front. Shot. Good chance for Cameron there for the fourth goal.
Absolutely. Nice save by Wah to keep him from getting the number four.
Timofev keeping it alive, but picked off now by the Lynx. They bring it center ice, chipping it into the corner. Ruslan chases it down with some resistance there.
Yeah, I wonder what Nealon thinks here, Joe, coming to Bradford here, this nice sunny weather just coming from California.
It's definitely curiosity on my part. I'm wondering what he's thinking of the weather for sure.
Cameron knocked down there, but going hard to the net again. There's no give on him. Like we said, there's going to be a penalty. I believe that I think Cameron's going to take that penalty at the back end there. I think it's going to be for interference.
He doesn't know why.
A little frustration, I believe, there. He got checked pretty hard there and then got back up, and referee made the right call.
5:24 left here in the third, 8-6. This could be, are we going to get a timeout, Bill?
The Lynx are going to take a 30-second timeout here. But it also
this
gives
is how you mount a comeback, right, Bill?
It is so, and it also gives the Rattlers an opportunity to set up for this to kill this penalty.
And again, you see Matt Hamilton with the lead on it.
Yep. And again, when you talk with experience on the bench there, you got three or four guys on the bench here for the Rattlers. And they're all their heads are looking to explain what's going on here. This is a education you do to get ready for the playoffs, which we'll see here in another month or so, Joe.
It's going to be exciting 2017. I keep saying it, but I know, you know, it's all competitive teams left. And any given night, the parity has been just completely out of control this season more than most.
Any given Sunday, Joe.
Any given Sunday. Lynx win that. Obviously had a good conversation, but Matt Barrett foils that. He gets it to Muhammad Kuchuk Yildiz, brings it over the blue line. He'll go all by himself. Shot. Good save by Waugh. Lynx trying to get out of their zone. 5 minutes to go. 1:37 in the penalty to Cameron. Lynx with a shot just wide. They keep it alive. Matt Barrett, some good D again there, and he got rid of it.
Absolutely, and showed a little grit there. It knocked his man down.
Yeah.
And I'd like to see a little stand up there and take one for the team there.
Absolutely, banged along the boards. Vigar chasing it down with some help from Muhammad Kuchuk Yildiz. It's thrown up the ice. Hassan will chase it down, waving off the icing as it touched someone there. Wall played along the boards. Hassan trying to make something happen there. He decides to regroup there, Bill.
Yeah, he's just ragging the puck there, and they got five black and yellow bumblebees chasing around after him and can't get it off him.
Yeah. It's one way to kill the clock, Bill. Muhammad Kuchuk Yildiz.
And then they're going to take and then they take a penalty for hooking. Yep. Just a lazy penalty, Joe.
Yep.
And he couldn't handle him along the boards. And
frustration, like you said.
Absolutely.
100% pure frustration.
Number 98's going to the box for hooking. Deservedly so. Takes that opportunity away from the Lynx to get back into it here. So Nick Gribbins, he goes to the box for 2 minutes for hooking, and we'll play 4-on-4 here for about 15 seconds, and the Rats will have the man advantage.
Yeah, and there goes that plan of the comeback. Doesn't mean they're not going to take one. There's a good shot wide of the net, but that plan got foiled. 2 seconds left in the penalty to Cameron. And it's over, and he's not even coming out of the box. Bill?
Yeah, I'm not sure what
he's chatting with the other player.
Absolutely.
And now he's not realizing he's supposed to be out of the box.
Yeah, that's just...
That's not good.
No, that's just a mistake on his part. About 10 or 12 seconds there. Now he's going back on the ice again.
You think that may be intentional by the Lynx there? A little distraction to keep him in there? You never know.
Well, whatever it was working.
It was working. Cameron throws it along the boards. Gets it to Broomberg. Over to Muhammad Kuchuk Yildiz. Back to Broomberg. Shot.
Blocked in front. Lynx are doing a good job blocking the lanes on that. Broomberg getting a shot away.
Tied up. Vigar comes away with it. In front for Cameron. Couldn't get a shot off, though. They'll get over to Broomberg. Lynx really putting on the pressure. Hassan.
Well, they're playing a good box here, and they're not letting them have that cross-ice pass like they've been. But, again, you don't have the same two bodies out there either.
That's a goal, Bill.
Oh, yes. Nice shot.
Just had Justin standing still, Justin Waugh.
Yeah, he didn't expect that to come from Muhammad Kuchuk.
Timo Fab paying a little less this end of the period there, Bill. Do you notice that?
Yeah, I noticed too.
Saving him.
Going up the alleyway, going to the dressing rooms, a considerable limp on where he hurt that leg the other
night. Not 100% yet, eh? Dutraville wins that faceoff, gets it to Vlasic. What do we got? 1:52 left here in the third, 9-6. Comes the Lynx trying to do something with it, not giving up. Although three goals in a minute 30, it's doable, but Rattlers might not want to allow it. Nice save there by Lund. Good job by the Lynx keeping it alive. Another shot. Could have got away from him. Good save by Lund there.
Yeah, good cut.
He almost tucked right into that little hole.
Yep. Like I said, the Lynx are okay when they're down in the offensive zone, but they've had a little difficulty in the other end, in the defensive end of it. But they look pretty strong coming up through the middle. They've got some guys that can skate and move the puck.
For sure. Dutraville again wins the faceoff. Bappenchow tried to get it out. Lynx keep it alive. That gets thrown away there. Good hit there. Rattlers bench, love that. Last minute of play here in the game. Chip towards Lund. Lund will cover up, leaving us with 55.76. 9-6 is the score.
Well, Joe, we got less than a minute to go. I just want to wish you and your family a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays, and we'll see you the start of the new year.
Yeah, to you and yours as well, and everybody listening. We wish you a Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, Happy Hanukkah. Whatever you celebrate, we wish you the best. So we're winding down with 42 seconds left. Lynx not giving up. Michael throwing it up the ice. And there's a whistle. What do we got there, Bill?
Not sure what the call is there, but the men in the striped shirts are making sure that this doesn't get out of hand here with the less than 30 seconds left to go.
Looks like number six going to the box.
Yeah,
Bill.
He's going there for slashing. Devin Valiquette going for slashing, and that'll put the Rats on the power play again. We'll see some different bodies out here for this one.
Yeah, we got 31 seconds left here. Tied up there. Brisky finding some resistance there. Matt Brett, backhander. Good save there by Waugh. 17 seconds left. 9-6 is the score. Muhammad already with a goal tonight, trying to set it up here. 3 seconds left. There it is. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. 9-6 is the final score for Joe Todd and
Bill Fiennes.
We wish you good night.
And a happy new year.
Absolutely. Bye-bye.